So this video is going to show you all the GeoGebra tools you will need to use to make a construction. So let me just go do an overview of what the tools are. First of all is a move tool, looks like an arrow. Then there's the segment tool for drawing a segment. Ray tool for drawing a ray. Align tool. Intersect tool, which makes a point on an intersection of two lines or rays or curves or whatever. Then there's a circle with center and radius, it's called, and you can actually change the size of the radius of the circle after you make it using this tool. Okay, so let me draw a segment first. Just click and drag. And if I want to move either points A or B around, I just click on the move tool, as you can see here, and just drag it around. So it's the move tool. And if I want to draw a ray, click and drag again. And when I'm dragging, the endpoint of the ray is fixed, but then I can move around, and where my cursor is, that's where the second point is going to be to define the ray. So this is ray CD. And notice that the points are labeled in alphabetical order as you draw them. To draw a line, click and drag again. And it works the same way as the ray tool, except of course the line extends in both directions. And then there's a circle tool. This is actually the most important tool for constructions because a circle represents using a compass that you saw in the videos, and the circle is used for measuring distance. And it's used oftentimes to get the same distance in multiple places. So here's circle A. I just clicked and dragged on point A. And then what I can do is I can click on the steps. And then you'll see down here, C, circle with center A. If I click on that, it will actually show me that it's center A, radius 2.6. And I can actually change the size of this circle if I want to. So let's say I want to have two circles with a radius of 3. So there's my circle A with a radius of 3, and if I want to make another one, because I'm measuring a distance here, I would go back to my tools, circle, and I'll do a circle on point E. I want it to be radius 3 also. Well, I can't control the radius here, but I can go to my steps and then click on it here. And it says 3.1, so I'll change it to 3 just by deleting the 0.1 and then enter. And that makes a radius of 3 for that circle. Now, since a circle is usually not the main part of the construction it's used for measuring, I like to change the color and the size of the line just to make it easier to see what's what. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my tools, get my move tool, and I'm going to click on point A, or actually circle A rather. Let's do that. Click on circle A. Then when I do that, you'll see a little menu pops up for the line. So I'm going to change it to a dashed line. And also, I'm going to change the line thickness. And also, the line color. So I just made the edge of the circle dashed. So having the dashes on the circle with a different color and making it smaller, it just makes it really easy to focus on the important parts of the construction. If you have a circle here, that's the same color and thickness as your segments and rays and the important parts here. Sometimes it gets visually confusing. So this is pretty easy to do, especially once you have a little practice. And so you could do something like that and see how the circles blend in so much easier. And it's just easier to see the segments, because when you're doing a construction, usually it's the segments that are the important parts, and the circles are used for measuring the lengths. This intersect tool is a very important tool when you're drawing constructions also, because oftentimes you need to label points where a circle will intersect a segment or a line array or even another circle. So let's say I want to label the intersection of these two circles. I will click on the tool for intersect, and then I will click right there with the intersection of the two circles. And notice that the point is a different color. That's how I know it's an intersect. It's labeled a little different color. The point itself is a different color. Let's do a couple more of those. So this is an intersect here, and let's do one here. So if you need to measure a distance using the circle tool, and you need to have a point at the intersection of the circle and something else, you would do that using this intersect tool right here. So there are also undo and redo buttons here in the top, and those can be very helpful, of course. When you're done with your construction, you're going to need to make a shareable link for your teacher. And so what you're going to do is you're going to go over here to this menu, the main menu, and then you're going to go to Share. And then it's going to ask you to sign in, and then you can use your Google account for that, like your Gmail. And then you can go ahead and sign in, and then you'll get a shareable link that you can copy and paste into the text box down below for your teacher, and then your teacher can link to your GeoGebra that you saved and then look at it and also read your reflection to make sure it made sense to you. So I hope that's enough information to get you started, and if you have further questions, please feel free to message your teacher, and your teacher can definitely help you out from there.